If you are a freelancer or small business owner, handling invoices can be quite painful. You might still be typing data manually, or if you are using an AI, you might still be correcting the data manually because they tend to hallucinate. This problem stops today with this free N8N template, which I am showing in this video. You can reliably pick up invoices from a Google Drive folder, send it through the workflow, and then get neat, reliable data in Google Sheets. Let me show you a quick demo, and then we'll go step by step through the workflow so that you can use it and adapt it to your own use case. So I have 10 invoices here in my Google Drive of this kind. They have the same format, so coming from the same source. They are in this invoices inbox folder. And here I have a Google Sheet where I set up which fields I want to pick up. Invoice number, date, due date, subtotal, total, and then the payment details, bank name, account number, and Swift code. Then in the workflow, which looks like this, we will go through it step by step, but let me show you quickly how this works. So it's picking up the 10 invoices, then going through a OCR step, which is Mistral OCR, the best OCR available currently on the market. That breaks down the different elements on the invoice, and then we pass it through to Google Gemini 2.5 Flash, which can extract the data that we want reliably. Gemini has a high aptitude to collect data in a large context, and it tends to not hallucinate as much as other models. So we see that this has now gone through the 10 items, and now it's saving in the Google Sheet. And there we go. We've got our data saved. Get all the account numbers, bank names, invoice numbers, and then the Google Drive IDs. Now let's go step by step through the workflow so that you can simply download it for free and then adapt it to your use case. As mentioned, you can download the template from the link in the description to this video. Just open it up in a blank workflow and you should get all the elements here. All you need to do is fill in your credentials and then adjust a few things, which I will go through now. Let's start first with the extraction of files and understand how this works. We have two types of triggers here, a manual trigger for testing and if you have ad hoc processing needs. Then we have this Google Drive trigger. It's a very neat Google Drive node. So if you go to the Google Drive node, at the bottom, there are different triggers on changes to a specific file or folder. So here we will pick up the on changes to a specific folder. And this allows you to monitor basically a folder for when new files are added. Here you can set up how often it checks that folder. Here every day at 2 o'clock, for example. And then you can set up the trigger when there is a specific change to a specific file, if there was a master, but here we say changes involving a specific folder. And then you specify the folder. All your folders should come out here in this drop-down menu. So that's very handy. For this to work, you will then just need to activate the workflow and then every day at 2 o'clock or whatever interval you set up, the workflow will start. So we have two different things happening here. First, we are getting the schema or the fields that we want to process from the Google Sheet, which will ultimately save the data. If I show you the schema that I have, second, Google Sheets. The schema is basically the first row of the sheet. ID here in A1 must stay always, because this is where we are going to save the Google Drive ID, which we'll use throughout the workflow. But all the other fields, it's up to you to change. So whatever you need from the file, you just write it here on the first row, and these will be picked up automatically by the workflow in this field. So you need to just specify, this is a Google Sheets note, and we will specify get rows in sheet. So it picks up basically the file here from the list. You have to specify it and the sheet in that file, which includes the data. The trick that we are using is we're defining in the options a range where we say we just want the first row and the data is in the first row. That's a little bit of a workaround to get that schema because I could not find another way. So what will happen is that you will get that first row both in keys and values. And this code block here basically just processes and this information and extracts just the schema with a list of the fields that you are interested in. Then we go to this Google Sheet, which will get the already processed files. And this is where it's important to have that Google Drive ID, because we're gonna also load here from the Google Drive node, load all the files from that folder. And in the merge node here, we're only going to keep those that don't match on ID. So if you have already the IDs in that sheet here, and the ID is coming from the Google Drive, they match, this node will say we don't take them further. They have already been processed. And it's only the IDs from the Google Drive node that are not found in the Google Sheet that will then go forward. So it's a very neat process so that we don't have duplicates and only work on new files. So now we continue further in the workflow. After that filtering node, we will download the files from the Google Drive. There is no need to modify anything here. It just picks up those IDs and gets them from Google Drive. Then we have the step where we're going to extract the information from either the images or the documents. And we're going to use Mistral OCR. If you're not familiar with OCR, this is optical character recognition. Mistral is an open source company that has basically created the state of the art in character recognition. They're much better than all the more generic models like 4o and even Gemini. Level of accuracy that's also matched in other languages than English. So it's really the state of the art and it's cheap. You just need to get an API key and it costs less than 0.1 cent dollar per page. So it's very cheap and so far the most powerful model for this workflow. The if node basically just checks what type of file we have. If we have an image, we're sending it through its own workflow here because it's just two different formats that we need to send to Mistral with an image URL instead of a document URL that we have here. All you need to make these three HTTP nodes work is to add that API key from Mistral and add it as a credential type. And then you will update it here. So that should remove the warnings that you have when you open the template fresh. One great thing here is that we're uploading the files to Mistral and getting a signed URL. This means that those files are not publicly available. They are only saved for you. So that's also a plus for data privacy and sensitive data. Only this workflow has access to that data. So Mistral then picks up all the data that's in these files and puts them into structured outputs. Specifically, the markdown is the one we're going to use where everything is aggregated. Then we have a code block here. We do two things. For multiple page documents, we are aggregating those pages so that we have one blob that we can send directly to the next step. We are also removing the Google Drive ID before we send it through the LLM. It's just a best practice. LLMs, even as reliable as Gemini, can sometimes change one character in an ID, and that can screw up the tracking of files. So we remove the ID here, and then we'll set it back in here in this code block. And this is just using Google Gemini model to extract the outputs that we need. It's specified here in this prompt. Extract the following fields from the invoice text with that schema that we pre-selected or retrieved in that one of the first Google Sheets in the workflow. So this uses Google Flash 2.5 Flash. It's very cheap. It's less than a cent per page, per prompt, and it's fast. It's a really good combination, Mistral and Gemini Flash. Then after we add back the ID, then we simply save the data in the Google Sheet. We select the file that we intend to save it in. And I have just map automatically and usually it works out fine. You can select map manually if you want more deterministic outcome. But basically, that's the workflow. In the same link where you get this free template, there are also add-ons for three different cases. If you need currency conversion, where you have invoices coming in different currencies, if you want to recognize the sales taxes specifically, or if you want to handle errors when there are missing fields. So please consider these add-ons. If you like this video, please click the thumbs up, consider subscribing. I hope this will save you a lot of time, and I appreciate you watching this video to the end. Thank you very much.